After bringing technology into your classes, you'll want to take a step back and reflect on the effectiveness of the technology introduced. Evaluating helps you determine whether the resources brought in are working and where you need to make changes. Of course, there's no set way to make assessments, but there are some pointers to keep in mind. Because the primary goal of technology integration is to enhance students' learning, a good way to measure the effectiveness of your technology is to evaluate your students' use of it. When you see that your students know how to select and use technology to help them find, analyze, and convey information effectively and creatively, then you have a good indication that the goals of technology integration have taken place. As an educator, you're probably familiar with standard methods of assessing students' achievement, such as multiple choice or even short answer tests. Like evaluating students, there are also ways to evaluate how well technology fits into your class and curriculum, or whether it has had a positive effect on learning. Sometimes, using traditional methods of assessment work well for measuring the effectiveness of technology. However, sometimes you'll have to look to alternative assessments. It just depends on the skill or learning you are trying to measure. Specifically, are you measuring the effectiveness of technology as a teaching, learning, or creation tool? For instance, let's say the learning objective for your students is to learn how to multiply, and the technology you decide to use to help students reach this objective is an online or CD math tutorial. In this case, a simple test consisting of multiplication problems will work well in determining how effective the technology was for meeting the learning objectives. On the other hand, suppose the learning objective for your students is to learn and demonstrate how useful Microsoft Office PowerPoint is as a presentation tool. No amount of multiple choice, fill-in-the-blank, or essay questions can convey this as well as having your students create a presentation using the program. You can then determine their level of aptitude using alternative assessment tools. Before learning about some alternative assessment methods, try this activity. What questions would you ask yourself about the technology you've brought into your classes? The questions you ask will depend on what you are trying to measure, such as technology as a teaching tool or as a creation tool. You can check your list against our recommendations and then click Next to continue. The alternative methods of assessment that we'll look at are teacher observation, checklists, rating scales, and rubrics. Remember, these tools can help you assess student projects, which in turn help you assess how effective technology integration has been. In other words, these tools are what you can use to evaluate the effectiveness of technology integration. Often, something as simple as teacher observation can be extremely helpful. The key is to actively and thoroughly examine students engaged in technology. There are many observations you can make that indicate how well technology fits in a class, and we've listed some of them here. Take a moment to review them before moving on. Another assessment tool is the checklist. Checklists allow you to specify your criteria and easily mark whether each point is met. For example, with the PowerPoint project mentioned earlier, if most points are met, it might mean that integrating PowerPoint was successful. Rating scales are very similar to checklists, but are more involved, as they don't just let you specify whether or not certain criteria were met, but they also let you assign a number indicating how well the criteria were met. We've listed a rating scale that can be used with the same PowerPoint project. Lastly, rubrics are an excellent technology assessment tool. Just as rating scales are more detailed than checklists, rubrics are more detailed than rating scales. They're typically sectioned into categories under which are listed the criteria and elements of achievement according to different levels of quality or stages of development. To get an idea of what we mean, you can examine the rubric shown here, which can be used with the PowerPoint scenario. After your first evaluation, you'll want to reevaluate at regular intervals, perhaps every year. Ongoing assessment is necessary, as variables are always changing. You won't always have the same students, and your learning objectives might evolve over time, so the technology you have won't always be appropriate. Continuous assessment keeps your integration efforts effective and current. Here are some real-life examples of how the concepts discussed in this lesson could be used in a classroom, either as a teaching tool or an administrative aid.